You deposit $5,500 into a bank that pays 3% annual interest compounded monthly. What equation can be used to determine the account balance after 2 years? What is the account balance after 2 years? And when will the balance reach $6,000? So we'll be using the compound interest formula given here below, where P represents the principal or initial investment amount, R is the annual interest rate expressed as a decimal, N is the number of compounds per year. Notice how N occurs here and here in the exponent. T is the time in years, and A is the amount after T years. So to find the equation that models this account balance, we'll have A equals the principal or starting amount of $5,500 times the quantity 1 plus the annual interest rate expressed as a decimal. 3% as a decimal would be 0.03. Remember, we drop the percent sign and then divide by 100 or move the decimal point to the left 2 places. N is the number of compounds per year. It's compounded monthly, and there are 12 months in a year, so N is 12. So we're going to raise this to the power of N times T. So again, N is 12. And T is the unknown time in years. Let's go ahead and find this sum here. We would have A equals 5,500 times of 1 plus 0.03 divided by 12. So we have 1.0025. Raised to the power of 12t. And now for the second question, to find the account balance after 2 years, we just substitute 2 for t. So we could say A of 2 would be equal to 5,500 times 1.0025 raised to the power of 12 times 2, which of course would be 24. So now we'll go back to the calculator. We'll go ahead and round this to the nearest cent. So the account balance would be $5,839.66. Now for this last question, we want to know when the balance will reach $6,000. So they're giving us A. We want to solve the equation for T. So now we'll be solving an exponential equation in which we'll use logarithms. So A is going to be 6,000. We want to solve this equation for T. So the first step is to isolate this exponential part. So we'll divide both sides by 5,500. This simplifies to 1, 6,000 divided by 5,500. Notice how this is a repeating decimal. So we'll go ahead and leave this as a simplified fraction. So we'll press Math, Enter, Enter. So we'll leave the left side of the equation as 12/11. So over here we'll have 1.0025 raised to the 12t power. And now we're going to take the natural log of both sides of the equation. When we do this, we can apply the power property of logarithms here and move this exponent of 12t to the front. So now we have the equation natural log of 12/11 equals 12t times the natural log of 1.0025. Now we're trying to solve this equation for t, so we're going to divide both sides of the equation by 12 as well as natural log 1.0025. Notice on the right side, 12 over 12 simplifies to 1, as well as these two natural logs, So we just have t on the right side. So t is equal to this quotient here. We'll have to get a decimal approximation on the calculator. So the numerator is natural log 12 divided by 11. And the denominator is going to be 12 natural log 1.0025. Notice how we have a set of parentheses around the numerator and denominator to make sure it calculates this quotient correctly. So t is going to be approximately, let's say, 2.9 years. Comparing this to our answer for the second question, this does seem like a reasonable answer. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.